Hello, friends. Greetings from me to you and welcome to this Facebook Live broadcast where we are free to share about all things without fear or favor. And I want to welcome you as a friend, as a family. Feel free to share with us, all right? It's free of charge. We are not here to make money and we are not here to make followers. Rather, we are here to wake people up. So let us get to it. I want to share with us another important topic, which I titled, If You Are the Almighty God. If you are the Almighty God, what will you do? But I want to start by saying, like, when you say Almighty, I want us to see the definition of Almighty. Like in my tribe, it means ikenile. That's onye nwere ikenile. Somebody that have all power, he can do all things. Because when you have all power, you can do all things. So let us see what dictionary say about Almighty, and see the definition. He said, having absolute power, all powerful. Having absolute power, all powerful. Informer, like great or extreme. Somebody that have extreme power that, you know, he's above all. He can do all things. There's no limitation. There's no reason that the person that possess all power can be limited. And that's why when it comes to people that believe that God is punishing them or God is not answering their prayers because of their sin, why you believe that God is almighty, how can your sin hinder the Almighty from helping you in your time of need? How can the Almighty let your sin stop him from helping you when you are sick, in need of healing, when you are hungry, in need of food, when you are disabled, in need of strength? He is the Almighty God. Your sin shouldn't be a problem. But men made up this God and said, God, their God is Almighty. But there is no such thing as the Almighty God. Because if there is any such thing or anyone that is the Almighty God, that God should not be limited. It's not a God you can even worship. It's not a God you can pray to do anything for you because he's Almighty. He has the power to know your problem before it comes to you. He has the power to intervene and stop that problem from coming to you. For the Almighty to test you is a lie. You say somebody is Almighty and is testing you. You are not Almighty. But wait a minute. Ask yourself, why do people say that God is Almighty? So, which God is not Almighty? You are the God. They tell you you are not Almighty. He said, no, you don't know everything. You can't do everything, but God can do everything. But the truth is that that God they tell you that can do all things does not exist. The God they call the Almighty God does not exist anywhere. It's all made up. Men made it up. It originated from the minds of religious men or men that are curious. Men cannot figure out why certain things happen, why they can't understand all things. They said, oh, there's higher power that is controlling that. No. Nature run its course. It's not any higher God that is controlling anything. That's why you see sometimes you say it's bad or it's this. It's not the Almighty God behind it. Yeah, many of us still say we believe in Almighty God because, oh, something was happening to me. I don't know how I get out of it. And you call it Almighty God. No, there is nothing new under the sun. What is happening today has happened before. The reason why you call it a new thing, because that is the first time you saw it in this your state. But you see, when you dig right deep inside of you, you begin to see more. Just practice sometimes. Close your eyes, and you begin to see certain pictures. that if you are able to comprehend it and put them down, they amount to something. But because you have been brainwashed, you have been indoctrinated, you have been taught to be afraid even of yourself and fear God and see God is the only one that can solve your problem, only one can hear your prayer, anyone can do this or do that for you. Religion turns you away from you to an imaginary being they call the Almighty God. If the Almighty God exists, the world will not be in chaos as it is today. If the Almighty God exists, he will fix the world as we think it is not good. But you should know that these things are happening because there is nothing new under the sun, and certain men decided to create things to control others. What you call evil today does not exist except in the mind of men. And they begin to practice it against their own fellow human beings. Then you call it evil. And they also call it sin. You see, religion made sin. There's no such thing as sin. It's when you go against the doctrine of a religion, they say you are a sinner or you have sinned. But as human beings, we don't know anything called evil. We don't know anything called sin until religion came. And you can see, those of you that believe in God of the Bible, he said he created evil. So evil is not of nature. It is of the God of religion. The God that gave the religion, he said he created evil. He said he created destroyers to destroy. So if you believe the Almighty God created evil and created the destroyer to destroy, why are you praying at all? Let his will be done. If you want you to die, you will die. If you want you to live, you will live. But all that is a lie. You know Almighty God is keeping you alive. It is religion that taught you that. So if you are the Almighty God, tell me the truth. Will you allow the evil going around in the world to keep going on? You say, no, it is according to his purpose and his will. How can evil be his will for you? How can? You know, religious people always say this. My cousin said that yesterday on the Facebook live broadcast I made. He said, I have tested God and he has proven himself to me. That's a selfish statement. God is supposed to be the God of all flesh, whether you are good or evil. When your Bible said that when the whole nation of Israel came out of Egypt, right? He said he suffered no one to do the wrong. Whether they are bad or evil, it doesn't matter. That's what the Bible tells you, right? So apply it. If the Almighty God is the creator of us all, what make you think he should be selfish or he should be partial to you? You say you have tested God and he has proven himself to you. How about others? How about other people? You say you have seen God and you know God. How about others? But as I've been saying, the truth is this. Nobody has seen God. And if anyone say he know God or she know God, that person is delusional. That person is lying. That person don't know what he's talking. He need his brain checked. No one can see God because God does not exist. I mean, God Almighty. You know what it means to be God Almighty? He has all power. He's not limited. Nothing can stop him from doing anything. And if this Almighty created us, think about it. If you are God Almighty, will you allow Satan to tempt and trash your creation or your creatures? If you are the Almighty God, will you allow evil to befall your children? If you are the Almighty God, will you allow your loved ones to die prematurely? Think about it. Many of you running your mouth on the social network, especially against me, saying, oh, you are speaking against God. God is good to me. How can you say that when many people are dying in your family, in your village, and you are saying God is good to you? Why not God good to those people also? Why is your God partial? Your Bible said God is not partial. He said everyone that call upon him, he answers them. So he did not say everyone that belongs to Christianity or everyone that belongs to Judaism. No, he said everyone in every nation that calls upon him and walk righteousness, he hears them. So why is that God not for everybody, even people in your village? It's like somebody that traveled from his village from Nigeria and come to America, maybe become a doctor and make a huge amount of money, or become a believer, or whatever he became in America and make money. Then now he said, God has blessed me. How about your people in the village that are suffering? There are some people in your village that cannot eat 2 square meals. Even some of them don't have anything to eat. They have to go and steal in secret. And when they catch them, they kill them. Why are they killing them? There should be no reason for anyone to be hungry in life, lack any good thing to eat, if there is God Almighty. Quote me. If there is God Almighty, there is no single person that's supposed to be suffering in this world. If you are the God Almighty, will you allow anyone to suffer? Let me use myself as an example. When I see little children suffering, tears start coming down my cheek. I hate seeing people suffering, whether old or young. I hate it. But see what is happening today in Yemen. See what is happening in your village. See what is happening in Nigeria. See what is happening in Africa. What is happening all over the world? People dying. You see how people are rushing to come to America, running away from their countries, running away from their villages. Then this majority of these people will still have the mouth to say, God is good to me. God has been good to me. How about your people? Some of us will never go back to our village anymore. Not because we don't have money. No, because we are afraid of dying. You are afraid that that elderly man will kill you because you believe they have some mischievous power or evil power to kill you. Maybe they have killed your parents, killed your siblings. You are the only one remaining alive. Then you run away. Or you have maybe a couple of siblings remaining. You take them and run to the city. Yes, many of you can't go to your village. You go to your friend's village to have life. Because you know, the moment you go there, some people ignore the signs, and when they say they want to build in their village, they just start foundation, boom, they die. Mysterious death. Where is that the Almighty God? If you are the Almighty God, will you allow such thing to happen? Won't you allow your village to be prosperous, to be blessed, that people will say they don't have to travel outside for greener pasture or to earn a living? If you are the Almighty God, won't you make the roads in your village, everything working in your village? You say you worship the same God that people worship in America. Why is your God blessing people only when they travel to abroad? When they travel to America, when they travel to Europe, when they travel to Asia, and you know, there are many daily things we do in abroad, our people do, to make it. Then after, you will say, God has blessed that person. God is so good to them. Which God? The same God that cannot be good to the people in your village? Which God gave those in Europe, in America, in Asia, the brain to do the exploit they're doing? Why not that same God give you and your people the same brain in your village? He said, no, you don't understand the ways of God. It is the will of God. Nonsense. What type of will of God is that? Some people are suffering, some people are enjoying. It is not the will of God. It is will of the wickedness of man. It is the purpose of the wickedness of man. It is the work of the wickedness of man. It has nothing, anything to do with any almighty God, or any silly God, any weak God, any Satan, any devil. Those beings does not exist. It is you and I that exist. We are the gods. We have might. None of us is almighty. It's when we come together, we become almighty. And together, we can make things happen, great things. But religion succeeded in dividing us, making us to see ourselves as useless, as unworthy, as sinners, as evil, as imperfect. You see, some of us, we open our mouth and say, no, I'm human, you know, human. Human is powerful. You don't know what human is. The human you are talking about is the religious version of human or humanity. They tell you, oh, human, you commit sin, you do this, God punish you, or God bless you, all that. No. We all, if you know you don't want anybody to kill you, will you have any plan to kill anybody? Think about it. Then why do you see some people have the mind to kill? Religion. It started with men. Because men have the power to think. Remember, even in your Bible, I think Genesis chapter 11, verse 6, if I'm not wrong. You see the story they put there. Remember, they stole that story from our ancestors, plagiarized it and put it there as the word of God, right? They say when men begin to multiply, they came to a city and to a place they said they want to build a city. And the tower that will reach up to where? Heaven. You see the story? And they say, God, look at them. The Almighty God was there. He did not know when they planned this. But when he began to see what these people are building, he said, come, let us go down. He said, these people, that which they imagine to do, nothing will be refrained from them. Let me read it for you. Remember, I don't subscribe to the Bible. I scrutinize it. All right? So this is what they stole from our ancestors or the ancient people and put it in the Bible to show you. Even people, when people join together, the Almighty God that they gave to you cannot stop them. He has to come and confuse them, put confusion among them, disunity. That's why there's no peace on earth, because evil men keep sowing seed of discord, disunity. They come among brethren and they separate them. See how Africa is today. It is because of disunity. Africa fell for that invasion because of disunity. Not because Europeans were more powerful than Africa. No. Africans went to war against them and we are beating them. So these people find out, no, just let us confuse these people. Like in Nigeria, like they said, Agowan said, had he been, he know what he know about politics and Igbo people, they wouldn't have need any gun to fight any war. All they would do is just get some Igbo people, the foolish one, the sellout ones, give them money. Then they will bring this unit among them. You say Biafra, they're not Biafra, as you see is happening today. Because they know when those people fighting for Biafra unite together, you can't stop them. But right, they divided them. They say, okay, go get it through UN. UN give you Biafra. UN that is getting more from Nigerian government than you. You think they will give you Biafra? You're joking. You have to. I think Nnamdi Kanu said something about that in his last video that I watched. But the problem is this. He keep mixing God. He call it Chukwuka Biama with the UN. If Chukwuka Biama can do all things, as Nnamdi Kanu said, he don't need UN to get Biafra. Nnamdi Kanu said that. He said, oh, you need the people in power to, you know, to achieve maybe referendum or freedom. But how about the God he also talking about? You see, that's confusion. And that's why there's no place you will have religion and have peace. There's no place you will have religion and have freedom. Religion is against freedom. And what if Nnamdi talking about Biafra, I love that. But the moment he start talking about Israel being the Holy Land, Chukwuka Biama, Elohim, do this, send me. No, many people have reason that are greater than Nnamdi Kanu, and they kill them. That no God stop them from killing them. The same thing happens today. They can take you. Nothing will happen. If Nnamdi Kanu dare to go back to Africa without fortifying himself, they will smoke him. It's a small thing. And nothing will happen. You know about great leaders, revolutionaries that have risen in Africa, and they kill them. Still today, nothing happened. It is in the world, and the men are the one doing that, not any God, not any Satan. Yes, I saw a video earlier today where South Africa had a Chinese man in church as a pastor. Of course, they will listen to that man better than the South African man, of course. Because some of them are also looking for opportunity to travel to China or go abroad, okay, so... I used to believe that also. So most of us from Africa, we believe that. That's why we fall cheap to all these so-called prophets and the men of God, and they're exploiting us. All right. So let me go back to what I'm saying again. If people join together, they are force you cannot stop. A force that no God, even the one you call Almighty God, cannot stop people. And think about it. How can you say there is Almighty God? Then he need people to tell him or to pray to him to do something. Think about it. If he's Almighty God, he don't need your prayer. He don't need your worship. He don't need your cry. It's like telling me that you are waiting for your child to cry before you save him from a snake that want to kill him. No. For the first time you see the snake, you put your child in safety place and attack the snake and kill it. But when will the Almighty God kill this snake that has been deceiving and biting his people, deceiving and biting his children? And he said, no, he will heal the wound. No, we don't need the wound in the first place. We don't need the sin. We don't need the evil. We don't need the temptation. We need a peace of mind. We need to live in freedom. That's what you need. We need. But because it is all made up, that's why it keep going on. No matter even how long you pray to that Almighty God, the evil keep going. Genesis chapter 11. I think I still know it. I don't cram Bible no more. I used to do that crap. See, he said God is almighty. Hear what they put in the Bible about God. Remember, it's a story. It's a fairy tale. Okay? He said, from verse 4, he said, the people said, come, let us build ourselves a city. Not that God told them to. Today, you see people building church, say, God told me to build. God is not telling anyone to build anything. Even the one you read in the Bible, say God will tell Solomon to build a temple. God tell this person to build altar. God tell this person to build tabernacle. It is all made up stories. You don't need any God to build. It is common sense something. You don't need any God to tell you to build any church, to build any temple, to build any mosque, to build any tabernacle, to build any shrine, to build any dome, to build any house. You don't need God. It's common sense. When the sun hits you, when the rain fall, you to think and start building. They say, let us build. Let us build a city and a tower whose top is in the heavens. Not just heaven or sky. Say, in the heavens, they will build past there. So they tell us God is in heaven. We're going to build altar to heaven because we have the power and the way to do that. It says, and let us make a name for ourselves, lest we be scattered abroad over the face of the whole earth. So even God cannot scatter these people. They are the one that made the decision. This is what we do. They agree on that. They want to build a city. They want to build a tower. They want to make name for themselves so they don't scatter. They want to live as a family. Is it not a good thing for people to live as a family? Why would the Almighty God go down and scatter them? And you say he's God of peace. He says God that love unity. He says God that established family. But this is the family of a people. They say we want to build and build. God said, God, hear what God said. Verse 5. But the Lord came down. So he was in heaven. People were building tower to go to where he is. Now he has to come down. You know, think about it, how people put up this story. God is in heaven, and people decided to build towers that will reach that heaven. Then that God come down. He came down. He said, let me go down. These people mean it. They mean business. And they will get me here and find out I don't exist. So God came down to see the city and the tower which the sons of men had built. Sons of men had built. Not sons of God. Sons of God don't build nothing because that God does not exist. It takes sons of men to build. See all the building you see, they are built by sons of men. Because men have the power and the will to make things happen. Not any almighty God you believe and worship. He said, verse 6, and the Lord said, indeed the people are one. Is it not the will of God for people to be one? Why will the Almighty God come and scatter people that are one? And the same thing happening today, the religion preach peace. Oh, peace, we are all one. We are, they're lying. We are all one, but they don't want us to be one. That's why they have their religion. They tell you, if you don't believe in their God, you are going to hell. If you don't believe in their God, you are an unbeliever. If you don't believe in their God, you are a sinner. He said, behold, the people. I love that. He said, the people are one. Are one, and they all have one language. Who is against people having one language? In your Bible, it was not Satan. It was not devil. Who was against people being one? It was not Satan. It was not devil in your Bible. It was the Almighty God that you believe that gave you the Bible as his word. Think, it is not my word. He did. He said, people. He said, behold, the people are one. And they all have one language. And this is what they begin to do. Now, nothing that they propose to do will be withheld from them. That is the power of the sons of men. That's why sons of men invented the things we are using today. You see, I can communicate with people even in my village where I'm living in America. People all over the world, just by what the sons of men built, like computer, like internet, like iPad, iPhone, many things, light, they invented it, electric light. They make it possible. Some people that will come on Facebook later to talk trash about the simple truth and telling them now they don't have light where they are. So when they manage to wake up, maybe they pull their generator and maybe LEPA give them light for some few minutes. Then they will start typing nonsense. God is good for us. The God that cannot give you a steady power supply. God is good for us. God cannot give you high in speed internet. God is good for us. A God that cannot give you free Wi-Fi. Who created Wi-Fi? You will say God created it. Shut up. Wi-Fi is like the breath you breathe. It's like your breath. So if man can give you free Wi-Fi, like in America here, you go to public library or public places, they put free Wi-Fi. All you need is your phone. You start using Wi-Fi free of charge. The city council put that. They put that in every place. So if God created bread and gave us all bread, why can't he give us simple Wi-Fi in this age of technology? Why can't he give us free gas, free cars, free anything? He is the Almighty God. But he does not exist. That's why he cannot. Religion taught you that he exists, but they cannot prove it. They cannot show you, yes, he exists. They lied to us, and the truth is prevailing today. Hear what God said. People that are in unity, people that are in peace, these people are united, having one language, you know, having one project, how they want to live. But God kick against it. Remember, there's this sticker they used to sell in Nigeria those days. Say, man propose, God dispose. Why would God do that? Man proposed to do something. They did not propose to kill people. They only proposed to build tower that we need to help them build their city and live as a people without scattering everywhere and turn enemies. Is it not why we have enemies today? Brothers killing their own brothers because they scattered. Now, when their children grow up, they don't know their siblings no more. They don't know their relations no more. And they start coming against them. Now we have white people, black people, red people, brown people. Why we all supposed to be one until this God, who you say is not author of confusion, came down and sowed confusion among them? Hear what this God said in Genesis chapter 11, verse 7. He said, come. Who was he calling? Christians, we say Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. No, he was calling, according to the Bible, he was calling the angels, all right? He's God. So they say the angels are sons of God. Okay, so they were envious about the exploits of the sons of men. Then God and his angel came against sons of men. He said, come, let us go down and there confuse their language. He did not say, let us go there and kill them. He did not say, let us go there and fight. And that is how you win war, even till today. For you to win war, win any war, you have to be able to confuse the people, your enemies. If you can get them confused, you will defeat them. When you confuse them, they will start attacking each other. You know, they say, no, that thing you are doing is not good. We don't support that bill. We don't support that. We not approve that. Confusion among them. Boom. They fell. And that is the strategy the God of the Bible used with his angel against the sons of men. You cannot defeat the sons of men unless you confuse them first. He said, let us go down and confuse their language that they may not understand one another's speech. His speech, you know, when you have understanding of what somebody is saying, that's how you can walk together. Two cannot walk together except they agree. And God is against that togetherness. The God of the Bible is against peace. The God of the Bible is against unity. The God of the Bible is against family. These people were living as a family. They propose what they want to do. He said, no, I will dispose it. And he said, angels, come, let's go. Let's go and confuse them. Confuse their language so they can't understand their speech. You say, give me shovel. That's how we used to interpret it when we were kids. He said, give me shovel. He will bring head pan. He said, shut up. That's not what I asked. Confusion come among them. So the person you hit will run away from you and go out with another woman, they start having children. All right? That's how confusion came into the world. The first time we heard about confusion is from God. He confused them. He confused the sons of men. So why are you blaming the devil? And why are you saying God is not the author of confusion? Your Bible show you that God is author of confusion. He confused the language of the sons of men so that they will stop their project. So that they will stop living as a family. So that they will stop living as a people. It is in your Bible, not me that wrote it. No matter the translation, no matter the context you want to use to interpret it. But the truth is this, if Bible is the word of God, it does not need our interpretations. It does not need your interpretation because the word of God is supposed to be clear to everyone that he made. But it is not the word of God. It's something that people made up and put in there. But you said I'm talking nonsense and you begin to think I am attacking your almighty God. As I said yesterday, of course, it is not wrong to mock your God because Elijah in your Bible mocked the God called Baal. So whatever you call your God, whether you call your God Jehovah, or you call your God Yahweh, or you call your God Allah, you call your God Buddha, whatever you call your God, and you say he is Almighty God, I am mocking him. If he is the Almighty God, let him appear right here, right here, right now. Not in your dream, not in your vision, not in your prophecy, not in your ranting. Let God himself appear here. Whichever way you say God appears, let him appear. And all of us, we believe him. Not believe him, all of us, we know him and love him. How I wish you can show me that you are Almighty God so that I can love him. I used to preach him as you are preaching, but I've seen that he does not exist. As we were taught, I was taught so in the church as a child. I was taught so as a grown-up somebody in Bible school, Sunday school, Bible school, theological school. They taught me all that about God, but I'm proving that that God does not exist. It is all hearsay. It is all make-up belief. And that's why it is not working. If that Almighty God exists, you and I will not be in the situation we are in today. He said, but you are responsible that you walk in there. Excuse me, he is Almighty God. So he's supposed to know that you're about to walk into that trouble. You're about to walk into that sickness. You're about to walk into that sin and stop you from going there. He is Almighty. Why should the Almighty God testing you? Do you test your toddler? Do you test your baby? The baby that started walking. Your baby, when he started walking, he said, let me see if he step on that fire. You don't do that. You don't do that. You see, you try to secure the environment. You make the environment conducive so that even if the baby fall, you don't want him to hurt. He get up and keep walking until his feet is strong. And you say your Almighty God is testing you. Your Almighty God is trying you. Your Almighty God is tempting you. Now you will tell me, Bible says God does not tempt anyone. You are lying also. The same Bible says that God tempted Abraham. So if God tempted Abraham, why James said God does not tempt anyone with evil? He tempted Abraham with evil. He asked Abraham to go and kill his son. Is that good or evil? Hearing a voice telling you to kill your wife, is that good or evil? Hearing a voice telling you to kill your child, is that good or evil? I used to defend that nonsense from the Bible, but I don't no more. Let us call a spade and not a garden tool. Let us say the truth. Truth will set us free. It will never kill us. If God exists, God will not kill me for saying the truth, for saying the fact. No, he will love me more because that's what makes him the Almighty. He sees my heart, as you say. He knows what I'm saying. If God exists, I cannot speak against God that exists. I cannot speak against you unless you do something evil. So the God I have not seen, how can I speak evil against? I cannot say God is the one killing people. God is the one giving. I don't say that because that God does not exist. It is people that are making up that. When you create something without proper regulation or doing what it's supposed to do, it can create other things that become harmful to other people. It has nothing to do with God. Sons of men decided to build a city, decided to build a tower, decided to stay in a place and live as one people. God, Almighty God of the Bible, say no, I'm going to confuse them. And today, instead of you blame that God of the Bible, you are blaming Satan also that does not exist. You are blaming the devil that does not exist. You call me the devil. Your own brother, your own flesh and blood, somebody like you, you call me devil. When you call me devil, you are also devil. Call me devil for telling you the truth, you are also devil. So there's no such thing as the Almighty God. It is just a myth originated from the hearts and mind of people that cannot figure out why certain things happen that they cannot understand or control. They say it must be God. And you see people today foolishly applying it to their own effort, to their own sources. Somebody went to school. Maybe your parents train you through the school or you train yourself. You know how you beg for the money or you make the money to train yourself in the school. Then after graduation, you say, it must be God. It must be God. What? No. You pay the school fees for you to pass. You study also. It has nothing to do with any God anywhere. The God that made it happen is you. It is not any God in heaven. It is not any God in the mountain. It is not any God in the temple. It's not any God in the valley. It is you. You are the God that is making something happen for you. You are the God that is keeping yourself alive. You see, some people take their life, they commit suicide. So you can do that also, but you say no, because you are keeping yourself alive. Can God stop somebody from committing suicide? No, because that God does not exist. That's why you see people committing suicide. I remember one week like that, I saw the guy today, somebody visited him, you know, the chat. The following day, I saw in the news, he died. Train was coming, he just jumped in front of the train crashed him. That's the end of his life. God did not stop him. God will not stop you if you want to kill yourself. And God will not kill you if you want to keep yourself alive. It is you Stop believing the lies they told us in the Bible. They say God kill it and keep it alive. Where? It is people that kills and people keeps alive. You are God of the Bible. You are God of religion. Brought division, brought confusion among the sons of men. And tell you there are sons of God. Where do you see sons of God? Sons of God suffering like sons of men? Think about it. If you are the Almighty God, will you let your siblings, your parents, your people suffering the way they are suffering right now? I'm in America. My parents, my siblings, most of my siblings are in Africa. They are suffering there. Of course. All of them, whether rich or poor, they want money from abroad. They want money from America. No, even if they have 20 cars, they still want money from abroad. Because of the environment where they find themselves in, it is called hell on earth. Africa is hell on earth. Both the rich and the poor, they cry. All of them, both politicians and their supporters, all of them are suffering in Africa. And none of them have hope of tomorrow. They don't know what will befall them tomorrow. They are always living in fear. So they always want to run away because at least in America, you can know what will happen tomorrow. You will know if disaster is coming tomorrow and you say, I'm not going anywhere. Okay? Even if your house is on fire, they put some detector that will go off. So you run away. We don't have, most of us don't have that in Africa. Even some of them put it in their house, it does not work. Okay? Because power to power, it is not there. And the same people will come and say, I'm serving a living God. I know the God I believe in. I know the God I worship. You don't know the God you worship. Because if you do, your situation will not be what it is today. So if you are the Almighty God, will you watch in silence as evil men slaughter their fellow men for any reason? As we see it happening today in Yemen, it happened in Nigeria a long time ago, and it still happens in some part of Nigeria today. See, go to Cameroon and see what is going on there. Go to parts of Africa. You see people killing their own brothers and sisters for whatever reason. Where is the Almighty God you say exists? And you are asking me to prove that he does not exist. Fool, you are the one that says he exists. Why are you asking me to prove something you say exists? You are the one that says exists. So you are the one that's supposed to prove it, not me. So why are you asking me to prove that God exists when I tell you that Almighty God in heaven does not exist? Because if he do, he will not be watching in silence while people are killing each other everywhere in the whole world. Some people tell you, no, in the day of judgment, he will judge people, he will kill this. Why the evil men killing people? One evil man destroy many goose or destroy many good people. Then you say one day God will just kill him or suffer him forever in hell. What is that? That's nonsense. It's supposed to be right here, right now. Don't kill. If you kill, you'll be killed. Boom. People stand up straight. But you see, he said, who make the law? Don't kill. It's not any God. It is people that made that law, especially the killers. They are the ones that say, thou shalt not kill. After they kill your ancestors, they made the law. Thou shalt not kill. After they stole your land, they made the law. Thou shalt not steal. After they take your wives, your daughters, your sisters, and they say, thou shalt not take another man's wife. They made up those laws against you so that you don't revenge, you don't retaliate, you don't ask for payback to keep you below. And you believe that it is the word of God. Your slave master is not God. The people that gave you the Bible, they are not God. No God gave you the Bible. No God gave you the Quran. No God gave you the Torah. It is evil men that gave you those books. If you read them very well, you will run away from them. The reason why you still believe in the Bible, the reason why you still believe in the Quran, the reason why you still believe in Torah or any religious book is because you haven't read them well. You are just reading them as your guide. The day you begin to judge that book, scrutinize it, begin to research that book, you will pick race. You will run than the fastest man in the whole world from them. If you are God, won't you let your creatures, your children, be free from bondage? Regardless their weaknesses. Won't you do that? If you are the Almighty God, tell me the truth. Won't you allow or let your children be free from every bondage, from sickness? Some of you, you have lost your own child that you love so much to one sickness or the other because of one mistake. And you say you are serving the Almighty God. You have lost your loved one, your sister, your brother, your father, your mother, your siblings, your cousin, your nephew that you love so much, used to play. Like this day, one of my late cousins, his name is Mentus Esiobo. He died. He died. I am older than him. He died some years ago. But sometimes I see somebody that look like him in America. I just remember him. And this week I called the guy Mentus Esiobo. He don't know why. He just look like that, my late cousin. And you say you are serving the living God. Why there are many people dying under his watch? He's watching them and are dying. He can't save them. You say God has been good to me. After you go, you visited or you went to hospital and you get treated and now you better. You say, this is God. I wanted to die. Then at the end of year, this December, watch it. December, you suffer from January to December. Then December, you say you're going for Thanksgiving. I'm going for Thanksgiving. God has done marvelous things for me. He made my son to travel abroad. He made my sister to get pregnant. He make my brother to marry. He made this to happen. No, it is not any God. It is the work of the sons of men. And religion, instead of you, religion telling you to praise yourself, he say, oh, that man who should praise the Lord. Which Lord? The Lord they cannot see. You tell them to praise him. Let them see the God you are asking them to praise. Let them see the God you are asking them to believe. Let them see the God you are asking them to worship. My brothers and sisters, I used to do all that silly things in the name of God. You gathered in a funeral home of in a burial ground where they want to bury your loved one. And you see saying, for the life we live, God did this, God do that. God can keep that person alive. At least you believe in resurrection power. Let God raise that person. I mean young person. I don't mean old people that deserve to die. Like they go on and come back. Because death is not a bad thing. But young ones, people that you see, they are the prime of their life. People that are strong, about to do something. Boom, they die. And you start crying, oh, I just saw him last week. I saw him last month. I saw him last year. Now the news, he died. Death, what is happening? What have you done that? Then after you wipe your eyes, maybe one reverend or one priest come there and say nonsense and you bury the person. And they still tell you, yeah, the Almighty God, our God is Almighty God. Have hope in the next world. Why not in this world? If in a place like America, they can resuscitate somebody that's about to die, they put oxygen, you know, bring many things, doing everything on that person, begin to breathe well again and live longer. If men can do that, have you seen the machine in the hospital? It's not God that created those machines. Men like you and I, people that use their brain, they began to do that. They proposed to do that and they achieve it. But religion make you believe, no, it's God. It's God. God will come and tie your road. God will come and give you steady power electricity. God will come and give you this. God will come and give you that. And they even make you believe that God is one that put people in power. Oh, God will choose Trump. Oh, God will choose Buhari. Oh, God choose Mari. God choose this person. God is not choosing anybody in power over you. Don't believe that nonsense. It is men trying to exercise authority over you. And they make you feel like you are contributing to what is happening by asking you to vote. Your vote is nothing to them. They're just using it to get you be their followers. think that something is happening. But as time goes on, people's eyes will be opening. People's eyes will be opening. And as your eyes open, you begin to distance yourself from order, detach yourself. You begin to reprogram yourself aright. Because man has programmed you from your childhood. Now you have grown. It's time to you for reprogram yourself. Distance yourself. Distance yourself. And deprogram yourself. Begin to live a new life as I have done. And I'm experiencing real freedom. Not religious freedom that you will never have. They tell you, freedom in Christ Jesus. You can't get up when you want to. You have to get up when they want you, go to church when they want you, do something when they want you, not when you want. And you say you have freedom. No, they promise you freedom, but they can never give it to you. So I'm calling you to don't be mean like the God of the Bible. Don't be mean like the Almighty God that religion gave to us. It's a mean God. The God that is so mean, he's watching from a distance, and people are suffering and dying, and he's watching. Which you cannot do, unless you are crazy or you are mean like that God. Everyone that have sound mind, everyone that have human brain, they don't want evil to happen to other people. They always put themselves in the other people's shoe. If he pinch you, don't pinch other person. That is a normal way to live. Don't be like that Almighty God that religion taught us. The Almighty God that cannot solve your simple problems, even in your family. So let me say it again. You think I'm mocking your God? Yes, because he does not exist. So if your God exists, let him come and show himself. Let it start with you. When God shows himself to you, you say God lives in you and you don't know nothing. If God lives in you, you will know all things. If God lives in you, you will do all things. But the truth is this, you are the God. Religion say you are not. I'm pointing you to one imaginary God in heaven. They say, he's there. He's not there. Check it yourself. If that God is there, he would have shown himself long time ago before you were conceived. But that God does not exist. But you do. But you are not almighty. No single of us, no single person among us is almighty. All of us are mighty. When we join our might together, we become the Almighty God. Thank you, my brothers and sisters. Thank you, family and friends, for listening. This is what I want to share with you. Have peace of mind. Yes, it's possible. Peace.